Hi, I'm Joe Gersh, the Vice President of Engineering for Secure 64 Software Corporation, and today I'd like to talk to you about how DNSSEC can help you in your job as a systems administrator. Let's make you the administrator for a site called mysite.com. Now, this could be a e-commerce type of situation or financial, like banking and stocks. Could be a government site, could be an educational site. And what we want to do is to make sure that what you've done, all the work that you've put this together, is actually getting out to the end user of your site, the person running on a laptop. How do you know that this laptop user is actually getting to your site? And the answer is you don't. There are all sorts of attacks, and I like to show how DNSSEC can stop a classic man-in-the-middle attack. There are other attacks. There are things like cache poisoning or DNS redirection, malware that a hacker might have changed the data on your site, or what I'm going to show here, the man-in-the-middle attack, and I want to show how DNSSEC can stop that. What is a man-in-the-middle attack? Well, basically, the person at the laptop, Joe User, says, I'd like the address of mysite.com. It goes to the caching server at an ISP. The caching server gets the answer, and it should work. The trouble is there could be an attacker sending and bombarding this caching server with wrong information, the big fat lie in this picture, and giving the wrong address. So that this user, instead of getting to you, and you've done all this work to set it up, is actually being redirected to a different site, robbersrus.com, which passes information back and forth, and is listening in on everything going on, stealing account information, logins, passwords, all of that stuff that should be confidential. How do you stop it? DNSSEC is a way of taking everything in the zones and signing it with a digital signature, basically a cryptographic technique that says, here is my reply to you. I guarantee it with this cryptographic technique. No one can forge that. Now, when the laptop user says, what's the address of mysite.com? It comes through with the signature and says, this is the address, I guarantee it. Even if an attacker tries to inject the big fat lie, signatures don't match, it would be marked as bogus, you're not going to get through. So now you have a guaranteed path to mysite.com. This means that you can now, as a systems administrator, sign all of these zones with DNSSEC, and why should you bother? Because you want to protect your consumer, you want to make sure they're getting through to the correct place. Equally important, you want to protect your brand image. You want to make sure that if it's mybank.com, mystore.com, mygovernmentsite.gov, whatever it is, you're getting to the right place. So protect the consumer, protect the brand. There are regulations coming like FISMA for governments that says you need to implement this by the end of the year. There's the networks contract for ISPs that says you need to be implementing DNSSEC. But this is the big deal. Protect confidential information. Don't let the man in the middle steal everything. Protect it with DNSSEC. And later, in the future, new things can happen with DNSSEC, like protecting against spam with DKIM, or protecting downloads with digital signatures. All of these are going to make DNSSEC a really big event in the future, and you want to put it into your DNS servers now. Thank you very much. In our next episode, we're going to tell you how this can actually happen. Thank you.